I'm Alex Fierro. Pleased to meet you all, I guess. The newcomer looked up, and I forgot how to breathe. The wry smile and sharp features, the unearthly beauty, and those eyes. I'll admit that I was staring.
What? She demanded. Nothing, I lied.
The gender thing wasn't what surprised me. What surprised me was the way I'd reacted to Alex. How fast my impression of her had slingshot, and the kind of emotions that had stirred up.
I've never seen anyone do that. So quick and cold.
Halfborn leaned toward me.
There's no shame in being attracted, Magnus.
What? No, I wasn't... staring? Halfborn grinned.
I'm just... me. You don't have to get it, just, you know, a little respect. For the girl with the very sharp wire, no problem.
Her restless energy, her disregard for what other people thought of her, even her laugh. She reminded me weirdly of my mom. She grabbed my wrists and put them around her waist. I'm not fragile, and I'm not contagious.
I didn't say anything.
Shut up.
Shutting up?
The bride-to-be emerged from the hall. All the moisture evaporated from my mouth.
Sister, you look amazing.
She walked over and straightened my tie.
Yep, all better.
I need my chaperone to look much spiffier.
How did you know?
Know what?
When you walked in, you said, dude. How did you know I was male?
Just my perceptive nature, I guess.
Right.
Will you make me a trophy for my perceptiveness? She picked up a pottery shard and threw it at me. I closed the door just as it shattered on the inside.
My uncle's house. There's something I need to do. The idea of his company didn't bother me. In fact, I wanted him along. Alex hopped onto the four-poster bed. What are you doing?
Making noise. You're a strange person. I prefer the term fabulously weird.
I was used to my hair being much wilder and more wiry, but Alex took such glee in murdering my blonde locks, it was impossible to tell him no. She lobbed an apple at my chest.
Breakfast, and also lunch.
Alex, the more I find out about you, the more I admire you. Her expression was a mix of amusement and exasperation, like I was a cute puppy that had just peed on the carpet. Fish the phone out of my pocket and call Sam, will you? Then shut up so I can concentrate. Even under orders, pulling something out of Alex's pants pocket seemed like a good way to get myself killed. I managed, with only a couple of small panic attacks. I was sitting across the table from her, grinning at something she'd just said. I held Alex's gaze for a second too long, and things got awkward. It had hardly been an earth-shaking event. So why was it at the top of Alex's memories? And why did I feel such a rush of satisfaction seeing my dorky self from Alex's perspective? I clung to Alex. She clung to me. We were nose to nose under the blankets. Then, before I even knew what was happening, she kissed me. Her nose fit perfectly next to mine. Our faces aligned, our breath mixed. I wasn't going to die without doing that. Alex was a force of nature. She struck when she felt like it. She shook my foundations in a way that was powerful, but also weirdly soft and constrained. He clamped his hands on the sides of my gooey face and kissed me. I'm pretty sure Valhalla had to resurrect me several times during the course of that kiss.
Now go take a shower. You're disgusting. I'll see you at breakfast.
I'm great at following orders. I went to take a shower. Alex and I reclined next to each other in the lounge chairs. She reached over and took my hand. I didn't question the gesture. I didn't take it for granted. I decided just to enjoy it.
This is good. Yeah, it is.